thank you so much for coming in from Canada. I gotta tell you, you're a handsome man, but my God, you're a beautiful woman. I can't thank you enough.
Excuse me, ladies. I was wondering if you could tell me where I could find Jon Trosky.
Why are you dressed like you're ready to go do a race?
Why are you dressed like a nun?
Cause I'm in drag?
I'm in drag. For the drag race?
Not that kind of drag, you lummox! No! It's Pride Month! It's June! Remember how I made you dress like a leprechaun? Remember how I made you dress like the Easter Bunny? And then remember how we did for Cinco de Mayo the sombrero?
The Mexican thing, yeah.
Yeah, no. It's Pride Month. Tonight, drag race!
In my defense, this is a stunt studio. I just thought a drag race was a stunt-heavy event, and that's what you meant.
What are we gonna do, figure eights in the parking lot, man?
I would just do it in the street, where drag races are done.
You know how much that costs to shut down a street to do a drag race?
I didn't know, I thought you had to figure it out.
Insurance? No! No! I put it on Facebook, drag race, okay. And it was in big 80s.
Yeah.
So listen, I need you to get out of this, and go see Ronnie, and tonight it's gonna be you against Schultz, who, by the way, great name. Shirley Joe King. It's fantastic.
I don't get it.
Surely he's joking about it. Listen to me. Tonight, it's going to be you, Corey Orion, against Shirley Joe King in a lip-sync battle where you will lip-sync for your legacy! I'm not good with my RuPaul voice, but it was all right.
About Jon Schultz.
Yeah.
Okay. I've been going along with all these skits and all these characters. You want me to be a leprechaun? That's fine. But I don't appreciate him attacking me from behind during the middle of my song.
Look, guy. He's not.
How am I supposed to know he's not going to do it again?
All right. Here's how we'll do it tonight. Tonight, I'll let you go out and lip sync first, and then he won't be able to jump you, and then he'll do the lip syncing second. All right?
Okay.
Please, though, I need you to get out of this. Go see Ronnie. Shave that beard off.
I am not shaving my beard. I will do whatever you want, but I will not shave my beard.
All right, well, see what Ronnie can do with you in the meantime. We won't shave your beard, but you're going to have to tuck, so.
Tuck? What is that? Yeah, you got to mean?
Ask Ronnie. She's got it.
Ronnie, what the tuck?
Warning. The following show features kick-ass stunts performed by trained crybabies. Accordingly, Sanctuary PA TV and the producers must insist that no one attempt to recreate or reenact any stunt or activity performed on the show. Seriously, don't fucking do it. Never gonna make it. There's no way that you make it. Yeah, maybe you can fake it, but you're never gonna make it. Are you just gonna take that? Make them take it all back. Don't tell me you believe that. Are you just gonna take that? Or will you fucking fight back?
Welcome to the sanctuary, and we are live on Twitch.
So, tonight we're trying to put together a very special event in honor of LGBT Pride Month. And I wanted to try to express an art form that I think is undervalued. And in reality, I know this place started off as professional wrestling, and this was the sanctuary wrestling. But you know what's pretty much exactly like professional wrestling? Drag! Let me explain. I almost died. Let me explain. If I were to tell you a tale of a bunch of half-gay, half-straight performers all backstage putting on a bunch of spandex and sequins and boas and shiny outfits for music to hit and for them to walk down a runway to do a bunch of choreography for the cheers, the applause, and the laughs of all of you. Am I talking about pro wrestling or drag?
Drag.
Both. Pro wrestling kind of is drag. It's hyper-masculine, gonna kick your butt, sort of drag. And drag, well, drag is drag. Can I talk about something here as I'm here in heels? I don't know why men hate women so much, but I have learned a lot from this experience this past week. First of all, these nails. Oh shit, I lost one. These nails, you can't do anything with. Nothing. Nothing. You can't. It literally handicaps females. Smart play, gentlemen. The other thing that I don't know if you know, but I'm walking around like a pterodactyl or a T-Rex. I don't know who designed heels, but he has a special place in hell. And mascara! Why do you put this crap in your eyeballs? What is wrong with you? We don't care that much, ladies. We appreciate it, and I don't think we say it enough. So, gentlemen, excuse me, ladies, please all stand up. The ladies in the room, please stand up. And the men, please. Gentlemen, you give these women the biggest round of applause in the world for killing themselves for you. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you, ladies.
This is craziness. So, the point is, wrestling and drag are kind of the same thing. So tonight, we've done our best to pull together the smash combination artistically of what was pro wrestling and what is drag into the most fantastic stunt show I can produce for you. So I hope you all enjoy. We have several of the sanctuary stars. We have guys like Marcy Herrera. We have Jordan, our All-American hero. What? My intern just told me that Marcy isn't here yet, and I thought that he was just running late, and that's a problem, because I need a hero. I'm gonna need one.
Yeah. because I don't want to play around to his weird liberal fantasies and dress up like all these weird wackadoos in the back doesn't make me a bad person. And speaking of which, since it's opposite day all of a sudden, aren't you supposed to be dressed up like a boy? Snowflakes in the back. But when I win, believe me, you're gonna win. Believe me, I know it, you know it, they know it. When you lose and I win, you have to dress up like a man, like the good Lord intended.
Shaving your legs?
I'm not sure about that, and I'm not sure even about the wig and use the makeup. That's not what I came here.
Down.
You know.
Sit down. Let me talk to you.
I'm here to fight.
Let me talk to you for a second.
Yeah, whatever, you snowflake.
Oh my
God! Damn it!
What's wrong now, man?
What, you didn't see out there? You didn't see that finish? It was absolute bullshit! And now I lost my match, so now I have to participate in the drag show! You know what? I'm better than this. I shouldn't have to go as low as to put on dresses and makeup and dance all these songs. You know, I'm a good conservative. I have a career to worry about. My family's out there watching at home. Not to mention that everyone out there is going to think I'm gay.
Jordan.
What? What?
Listen.
Guys. No,
drag
guys.
Is not defined by being gay. It's defined as a performance art. We all came here to become better performers.
Yeah, right.
To become better men.
Yeah, right.
Do you want to know how we can be better men? It's by dressing up as women and learning perspective. To learn perspective, to see what so many people have to go through to feel beautiful about themselves. You both are handsome guys. But haven't you at least once in your life wondered what it's like to feel beautiful? Listen. I know it's confusing. People are always going to judge you by the way you look, but you cannot let that get to you. Andre, you're so much more than an immigrant from the Dominican Republic. Jordan, you're so much more than a Trump flag-waving Republican.
Yep.
My beard doesn't define me. I define me. You know what?
Oh, what are you doing?
Yo, John.
Dude, just... What the... What?
Oof. Oh my god.
Assumptions, stereotypes, are not what make America great. The actions of its people, and the freedom that we have to be anything that we want to be, that is what makes America great. So let's go out there tonight, and let's show America all that we can be. And it starts with me shaving my beard. And Andre, it starts with you shaving your legs. And Jordan, it starts with a tuck.
A what?
Come here.
What are you doing with that roll of tape?
The following stunt fight is scheduled for one fall! Ladies and gentlemen, straight from the factory, this is our completely plastic stunt drag dummy!
Come on! Finish it! Andre, his own!
Boobs, like, what am I gonna do, stuff socks in my shirt, or?
I think you've got enough to just tape across the front.
What do you mean by that?
Well, you just tape them together. As I said about the tape below, did, Ronnie talk to you about that?
No. What's the tape even for?
So, what you're gonna do...
Yeah?
Is, you're going to... You ever, try to tuck your balls into your abdomen? So you're just gonna take your you're gonna get it right up under the and you're just gonna push it up in. You're gonna hold that side, then you're gonna go to the other side and push that up in. Then once you've got both of them in there, you're gonna take your and you're going to tuck it towards your and then once you have it there, you can put a pad over to cover it, or you can just take tape, put it right over your into your area, stretch it around, and then attach it back here. You'll probably use about three pieces. So you'll have the one in the front, and then you'll have one to the side, and the other side, and the idea is to make a nice flat thing. No possible bulge or anything.
So, like a man
if that is what you want to call it.
It's like Buffalo Bill out there. It's ridiculous.
I mean, if that's the true test of ego, Jordan, is if you yourself.
Well, I mean, I would me. Me hard.
Gentlemen, Corey. Ladies and gentlemen, doing drag, her lip sync performance. This is Miss Tank.
Thank you.
And now.
That is good.
Making her sanctuary debut, Shirley Joe King.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now proclaim this
Enjoy the wine and chocolate.
and gentlemen, Miss USA.
Like the old time, not a lot of damage, damn my baby. I'm gonna try this now that we're on the rack. Zero chance I get it right. I practiced it all week and I expected it just to fail miserably like most of my life. It's okay!